And I'm pleased to say our Premier Gladys Berejiklian joined us live tonight from State Parliament. Premier, good evening. We heard today about all the screening measures in place at Sydney Airport for returning residents and visitors. It's still an honour system, though. If one person spoils it, would you make hotel quarantine mandatory?
Well, look, Peter, please know it's a very rigorous process. In fact, there have been examples where health staff have put people in quarantine following that rigorous process. If it's found that people have symptoms and they're swabbed and they're awaiting test results, health has been putting people in quarantine. The processes are rigorous, and if we need to do more, we will. But I want to assure the community that our government, our officials, are working around the clock not to leave a single stone unturned. We know what's at stake. It's a daily battle for us here in New South Wales, and I want to thank everybody for coming forward and getting tested. It's our high rates of testing that are allowing us to get on top of this. We are on high alert, but I also really want to thank all of the community for stepping up and doing the right thing, and I feel incredibly proud of that.
Okay, so hotels still on the agenda. That's interesting to hear. When we sat down in May, you told me you didn't care about backflips if the advice changed, a no regrets policy. What's stopping you, Premier, from making masks mandatory if it keeps us ahead of the game?
Well, absolutely, Peter, and it's up to the health advice. And we're actually being very cautious with our health advice now, and I want to again thank everybody for donning those masks. I've noticed, as I've been out and about in the community, that more people are taking up our health advice. And if we do take the health advice, if we limit our activity, if we're extra cautious the next few weeks, we will go down a path of New South Wales, not down the path of, unfortunately, the predicament Victoria's in. And I do want to extend our thoughts to all Victorians who are going through a horrible time, and we don't want to see that happen in New South Wales, and that's why it's really important for us to stay on top of it, to be cautious, to get tested and stay home and isolate, but also to take on those extra bits of advice that our health experts are giving us. The advice to date has been second to none, and they've been working around the clock, and it's why New South Wales, even though we're geographically very close to Victoria, we have 55 border crossings we share, and notwithstanding all of that, we've been managing to control the virus, although any community transmission is concerning because one case getting out of hand can cause a huge tidal wave, and we want to make sure that doesn't happen.
Do you want us to eat out, for example? Would you go and eat out right now?
Well, I'm being extra careful. There is a special celebration with a small number of people that I'm considering, but I've been limiting my activity, Peter. I would feel safe so long as the place I was going to had a good COVID safe plan. I wouldn't go into anywhere unless they had a COVID safe plan, unless they'd registered with Service New South Wales and done all those checks. So please do your homework. Book ahead. There's no reason why you can't do everything in a safe way. But I would suggest people who live in those areas where there have been cases to limit their activity. And we've noticed that. And the harder we are now on ourselves, the harder we work now, the better off we'll be in the long run. And that's why I'm really grateful that people have been taking the advice. The next few weeks are critical. We always said when we found out how bad the situation was in Victoria that 4 to 6 weeks would be a very critical time for New South Wales, and we're about halfway through that period. So thank you to the community for working hard this far. Let's keep going and stay on the path we're on because we have the opportunity to really deal with this in the best way that we can.
Very, very quickly, everyone really appreciates all the hard work you're doing and the pressure you are under during this challenging time. How are you going?
Thanks for asking, Peter, but I'm great. I just worry about the 8 million people of New South Wales, and that should be my worry. But I also know that whatever I'm feeling and the fear and the anxiety I might feel from time to time is what the community is feeling, and that helps for better decision-making in my view.
Okay.
And I'm just like everybody else. I worry about my parents in particular, and those concerns are top of mind for me.
OK, well, no doubt they're watching their daughter tonight. Premier Gladys Berejiklian, thank you very much for joining us.
They're watching you, Peter, that's for sure.
Thank you.